Have you heard in the news about artificial intelligence and how it will destroy civilization as we know it? How it will take away our jobs? How it will leave us mere mortals without a means of sustenance? If you've ever thought about that, play along with me for the next 5 minutes as I attempt to answer those questions and prove to you why those statements are both right and wrong. So, let's get started with the most prominent issue with AI: unemployment. Tech firms have laid off thousands of employees over the past few years. Why? The existing economic model prioritizes efficiency and assumes profit maximization at the individual firm level. Goldman Sachs stated in a report that AI will take away or degrade 300 million jobs. Many firms have frozen hiring for roles that they believe can be performed by AI. Where's the problem? The existing economic model relies on an exchange. Households provide the factors of production, such as labor, to firms. And firms in return provide factor earnings. Households then use these earnings to purchase the goods and services produced by the firms. Now, where does the problem come in? If firms use AI to replace jobs that earlier required human labor, households might not have the income required to purchase the goods and services produced by these firms. So, the loop is broken and the equilibrium of the existing economic model is disrupted. Economic theory suggests that there are two possible ways forward. The first, the income of households is reduced, and firms are forced to reduce prices. They can afford to do this because now they have low costs thanks to AI. This leads to a reduction in prices across the board, a deflation, potentially helping those on lower incomes. Ultimately, the demand is balanced. The second alternative. So what happens? Who retains that job? Highly skilled employees and uber wealthy business owners. The economy undergoes an ultra-premiumization. It revolves around these uber-wealthy business owners and highly skilled employees that retain their jobs. The economy serves them while everyone else is essentially left ignored. However, there is an alternate theory, the employment compensation theory. This states that any new technological advancement creates more jobs than it takes away. An example of this is that of the personal computer. A report by McKinsey shows that though the personal computer took away 3.5 million jobs, it brought with it 19.3 million new ones, a net gain of 15.8 million. It took away many old jobs in industries such as typists and office hardware manufacturers, but it brought with it many new industries such as software development and computer hardware manufacturers. For instance, there are even some jobs that AI cannot take away. Doctors. Although their productivity and efficiency may be enhanced, we will always require a large amount of them. Why? Think about it. What happens if AI gets a diagnosis wrong? Who is to be blamed? Humans are social beings, and for that reason, the human touch can simply not be replaced. All of this causes us to question the fundamental concept of employment. We believe that it's a requirement, but is it? This takes us to the famous economic concept deemed by John Maynard Keynes as the age of leisure. Humans only work for 10 to 15 hours per week, and they're able to maintain the same output or GDP with reduced work. How? Increased efficiency and productivity due to technological advancements. AI may take us to that future. A report by New Economics Foundation has shown that an increase in productivity is correlated with an increase in leisure time. However, there are some that argue that they work for more than sustenance. Their work grants them a passion and a deeper meaning. But there are many ideas being explored surrounding how we can overcome this. One of this is UBI, Universal Basic Income, where governments provide their citizens with the requisite income to maintain a decent standard of living. This includes housing, education, and healthcare, and more. Will this age of leisure grant us the ability to pursue and change our desire to pursue more meaningful projects deeper than sustenance alone? Well, if you've learned anything from past technological developments, such as the steam engine, the assembly line, and even the personal computer and the internet, it is one thing that they improved productivity and efficiency, but they all had one more thing in common. Humans did not settle. Due to our very nature, we chase economic growth. We are unable to settle for the same output with reduced work. An example of this is that of the internet. It was born in 1983 and despite the immense productivity and efficiency improvements, the average work week has remained relatively the same. So who's to say that it'll be the case this time? Will business owners continue to profit immensely while employees continue working long hours? It is us. Our choice as a society to play an active role in shaping the future. We must urge policymakers to take into account the depth of impact AI can have and ensure that frontier technologies such as AI are not used to increase aggregate output at the cost of increased inequality. So, to answer the questions I had posed to you at the beginning, will AI destroy humankind? Probably not. Will it change the future of employment? Definitely. And it's in our hands to decide how.